only when the education is producing the human being of higher consciousness, it can be called as education. There was so much peace, so much of research, development, so much of knowledge, knowledge creation and spreading, so much exploration on space, under the water, under the earth, so much knowledge was available. Even whatever is left out is unimaginable, unmatched. Humanity may take at least 5,000 years to catch up with Vedic knowledge. To catch up with our education system, they may take even 10,000 years. Understand the statements I am making are not out of ego, arrogance, self-pride or anything. I am simply stating the fact. Our education system, our Gurukul system, making human beings, should again become the mainstream education system. Teacher can always establish his superiority and let disciple not have incompletion. By the authority, you can never make somebody without incompletion. Only by your authenticity, you can make others complete.
Like how in outer world, kids and people used to play with toys and those things. But in Gurukul, we'll not play with toys. We'll play with deities. Like how Swamiji, when he's small, he used to play with deities and feel the connection between the deities, like that. Even in Gurukul, we does that and feel the connection with the deities.
Adding a point, like how she told, like before, actually, I want to share an experience. Before coming to Gurukul, I had a drawing teacher, like in my school, and he, whatever I do, he'll never encourage and he'll never let me like do explore on my own. He'll always tell like, this is the system, you have to learn like this, and this is the way to learn. And he'll like stop me. I used to feel so restricted. But after coming to Gurukul, Swami told, everything is like, everything is within you and you can do anything you want. You can just download and do it. And I started drawing on my own and I started exploring new different possibilities. And I felt so happy that I was able to explore different dimensions of myself. So this is how I feel like this Gurukul system will help you explore yourself and open up different dimensions in you. Because the whole Gurukul system just functions based on exaggeration on Swamiji.
Inner Awakening participants had an opportunity to visit the holy city of Prayag, also known as Allahabad. This is the place where the three sacred rivers, the Ganga, Yamuna and Saraswati, meet.
When human beings come and take bath in this river, their sins are washed. When incarnations land, the river's sins are cleansed. It is called Tirthe Kurvandi Dirthinaha. Tradition says the incarnations, whenever they are around the Tirtha, they should take bath, because that is the only way the Tirthas are purified. Srividya Homa. Worshipping mother. Please understand. Only with the blessings of mother you can enter the Shiva's home. She has the key. She has the key. It's mother who has the key. She is the Mokshadayini. She is Muktidayini. So today we will receive mother's blessings, Devi's blessings.
Yeah. भवन्तो महान्तो अनुगृह्णन्तु
तथास्तु
When they were chanting the Varahi mantra, I literally saw Devi Varahi sitting here and offering the and accepting all the offerings. That's when I tried to do the Yoni Mudra and do Namaskar. I saw Devi was present. She is and she accepted all our worship and gracing us.